Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Max Lowery and I'm the creator of the two meal day, which is the simplest and most effective method of intermittent fasting. With my book and my online meal plans, I've helped change thousands of people's lives using intermittent fasting. Today, I'm gonna be talking to you and taking you through the process of using DNAFit, SnapShot, and Diet Fitness Pro 360. So SnapShot will test your current health across five key markers: lipids, vitamins, inflammation, liver, and iron. And then I'm gonna use their Diet Fitness Pro 360, which is a genetic predisposition test. So the SnapShot tells you where you are right now, and the DNA test will tell you what potential problems you could have down in the future. Using these in conjunction is a really effective method to improve your health and track what's going on. So why on earth am I going to use this, and why on earth am I going to persuade you guys to use it? Well, I am obsessed with performance and health, but most importantly, what lifestyle factors can do to contribute to optimal health. Using current technology like these two tests are a really effective way to work out what works and what doesn't work for you. Because fitness, health, nutrition is completely personal, and what works for one person isn't necessarily going to work for you because everyone is completely different. By using tests like this, you can find out exactly how your training program or your diet or the food that you eat is affecting you here and now, and then potentially how it will affect you in the future. So with the current obesity and diabetes epidemic, it's really important that you guys have all the options and all the tools in your toolbox to make sure that you live a long, happy and healthy life. All right, so let's go for a snapshot first. I'm just using a knife to open it. Right, so it looks like you're gonna fill in your details. There's instructions. And here we have everything that you need. So we've got, this is where you collect your blood. And you've got three pinpricks. So this is gonna help you get the blood out your finger. And you've got a plaster, and you've also got an antiseptic wipe to make sure that everything is clean. And then you have the return envelope inside. Okay, now for DNAFit. Always read the instructions first. So, it's time to take you through my SnapShot and DNAFit results. And yes, I realize that I have a beard. Don't worry, it's not gonna take so long that you can grow a beard like this to get your results. I actually got SnapShot in less than 48 hours, in fact, and I got DNAFit in around 5 days, so really, really quick. It's just we've had Christmas and then New Year's, so I'm only just recording results, and in that time, I've managed to grow a beard for the first time, I may add. So, without further ado, I'm gonna take you through the results, which have been really, really interesting to see, actually, so let's have a look. Okay, so you're going to receive your results via email. As I said, I got a snapshot within 48 hours, which is pretty impressive. You're gonna log in and then you're gonna click through to snapshot, and you're gonna be taken through to this, which is an overview of my blood report. As you can see, we've got lipids, vitamins, inflammation, liver, iron, and then there's a summary. And these are the five things that it tests for. And within these, there's quite a lot of information about different results it's been testing for. So I'm not gonna take you through every single result because that will take forever and it's gonna be very boring for you because there's a lot of information here. You guys, you can take the time to go over your own results, but I'm just gonna click on the summary. So let's have a look at the summary. Okay, so results summary. I've actually got a doctor's comment, which is really interesting. I'm not gonna read it out, But it just really goes to show how personal this test is. You get a big kind of advice, big bit of advice from a doctor. So in here we have my in-range results and my out-of-range results. So virtually everything is in range, which is really interesting. My vitamin D, I'm really pleased with, because I do supplement with that. My inflammation was very low, which is a really good thing because inflammation can cause all sorts of different problems in the body. The only thing that was slightly out of range was my cholesterol and LDL levels. My total cholesterol was slightly elevated, although total cholesterol doesn't really tell you very much. But what is bad is my LDL was quite high, and LDL is the bad type of cholesterol. And then you have HDL, which was, for me, was in a good range, but my LDL is slightly elevated. I can tell you why this is. Up into the lead up to December when I took this test, my diet definitely wasn't on point. I was eating more fatty or bad fats, basically, and processed foods. So it'll be interesting now, it's January and I'm back into my usual eating habits, if I can have an effect on this. I'm planning on doing this every quarter, which I really recommend that you guys do, because it really, things change over the course of the year, and it just is a really good way of keeping track of what's going on in your body right here, right now. So let's just take a look at cholesterol to see what this looks like. So as you can see, my levels was 5.49. From my understanding, I believe that you want your total cholesterol to be below 5. So mine is slightly high. Not too worried about it, because there are lots of things that I can do to fix that. As I said, your total cholesterol doesn't really tell you very much. What's more interesting is the HDL and the LDL. So it tells you, you know, total cholesterol results, what it means, why you can change it, but also it links up to the DNA test, which is really interesting. So I'll go through the DNA test in a minute, because sometimes your genes can make you more predisposed to being sensitive to saturated fat. So yeah, as you can see, a lot of results here, really interesting to see. Let's just have a look at my vitamin D, which I was really interested to see. So yeah, vitamin D is right smack bang in the middle of being normal, which I'm pleased with, especially in December, because obviously in December, you're not exposed to sunlight, and I do supplement. So obviously the supplements that I've been taking has made a big difference. But again, there's more information about what you can do, why it's important. But if you guys aren't supplementing with vitamin D, I really do highly suggest that you do, because it's the one supplement that I've noticed a difference with energy levels, my immune system, I don't get ill in the winter anymore. It's really interesting. So let's go back to my dashboard, and we'll go through the genetic tests, which is where you can kind of combine the data from both the snapshot and the genetic testing to see what's going on. So I've already done it, but you can download an infographic that summarizes everything. We'll go through my infographic, because it's probably gonna be the easiest to see. So this DNA test tests for your training type, injury risk, but also genetic nutritional intolerances. So let's go through the training first. So as you can see up here, got my power to endurance response. And what that means is what am I built for? Am I built for more athletic, explosive, short sprints, you know, strength, powerful movements, or am I built for more endurance, long distance stuff? As I've known pretty much my whole life, I am not very good at endurance, and you can see this here. So actually 33% towards endurance, 67% towards power and sprinting activities. I was a competitive sprinter for 4 or 5 years. I've always been very good at short distance things. So yeah, it's really interesting to see that I was right. This is in my genes, and this is why I've started doing Olympic lifting. And what makes me feel good in terms of my training. It's not to say that you can't get yourself better at being an endurance athlete. I did recently do an ultra marathon, but it's just gonna be a lot harder, and it was hard. I've also got my VO2 max response, which is medium. And then interestingly enough, my injury risk is high, which I am not surprised about, because if I don't do a very, very long warm up before a workout, I will get injured. There's no doubt about that. So it's just reaffirmed, which I knew anyway over a long period of time, that I have to do a really long warm up, otherwise I cannot train properly. But then, interestingly enough, my recovery time is fast, which I am fairly surprised about. I always thought it took me a bit longer to recover, but yeah, apparently not. So really interesting. Having this training insights can help you train more intelligently. So for instance, I'm definitely probably someone that can train maybe four or five times a week with one or two rest days and be fine because of my fast recovery time, as long as I am doing a really effective warm-up. And ever since I've incorporated long effective warm-ups, I don't really get injured very much. But when I was much younger, I was tearing hamstrings, had all sorts of problems all the time. So now let's go through the diet. So essentially straight away, it has given me my optimal diet type, which is low carb. I'm not really surprised about that. Recently, I have incorporated more carbohydrates, quality carbohydrates, and I definitely don't feel as good eating them. I feel slow, lethargic, it messes with my hunger. Yeah, it's not great. So this is kind of reaffirmed that for me personally, that low carb does seem to work. But interestingly enough, my carbohydrate sensitivity is incredibly high, which I did know. If I eat refined carbohydrates, so sugar, sweet things, it really does affect me in a negative way. I really crash afterwards and I feel it in a big way, whereas other people seem to be able to eat these things and it's fine. But this is what is interesting. My saturated, so remember, my cholesterol levels were slightly elevated, and it did mention that this could potentially be because of genetic factors. So interestingly enough, I actually have a low sensitivity to saturated fat, which means that I can eat more than the average person. But even though I have a low sensitivity, my cholesterol levels still aren't great. So there's definitely something that I need to change in my diet. And it'll be really interesting to see when I do this again in March, after I kind of go back to my usual way of eating, to see if that has improved. Lactose intolerance, I'm tolerant of lactose, which I knew. Celiac predisposition is low, which I'm not surprised about. Alcohol sensitivity is interesting, actually. So I have raised alcohol sensitivity, which apparently means that I am someone, if I drink moderately, it can actually positively affect my cholesterol. I probably do drink moderately. I have maybe a few beers per week, and that would maybe explain why my HDL, which is good cholesterol, is in a normal range. So that's really interesting to see. So then you've got salt, antioxidant need, omega-3 need. So my omega-3 need is raised. So what that means is that I have a higher predisposition to inflammation in the body. Although, I didn't show you, but my inflammation levels were very, very low, which means that my lifestyle factors are preventing my natural predisposition to negative inflammation from happening. So I do supplement with omega-3s, I take cold showers, I do intermittent fasting, I sleep very well, I don't drink very much, I exercise a lot. So all these things are probably having a positive effect on my inflammation levels. So that's really good. Vitamin B need is raised, which is interesting, didn't know that, but all my levels were normal in my snapshot. My vitamin D need is raised, and that's probably why I felt so much better. I felt such a big difference when I started supplementing with vitamin D. And then you've got things like cruciferous vegetable need, Brussels sprouts, broccoli, cauliflower, and kale. I eat loads of those, so it's normal. My detoxification ability is fast. So that means that my body can get rid of free radicals quicker, which is a good thing. So really interesting. From my understanding, you know, this is my DNA, this is my genes. I cannot change these predispositions, but I can use lifestyle factors to prevent them from happening. So yeah, really interesting. And then you can use the snapshot to find out currently how your lifestyle factors are affecting your predispositions from this DNA test. So it's been really interesting to see, actually. And although I'm only showing you the PDF, if you go into your back end, there's a lot more information about what each one of these means. And it even goes into the information about exactly what gene you have and what that gene means. So there's a ton of information there. Okay, so thanks for watching. There's been really interesting results there. There's some things that I need to go and work on, and I'll be really interested to see when I do the SnapShot test again in March to see if I can have effect on those cholesterol levels. So really interesting. I really, really encourage you guys to give this a go. I actually have a 40% discount on both these tests. It's right here, and also the links are below. Use that 40%, and then you can really see what diet, what training, what lifestyle factors are having a positive or negative effect in your life. It just makes everything so much more intelligent and efficient. You know, technology is there to be used, so don't waste it. But if you enjoyed this video, if you want to learn more about the 2-meal day intermittent fasting, hit subscribe, and I will see you next time for the next YouTube video.